The start symbol is S. It's the first one to appear in our grammar. So one possibility is S goes to EE, which goes to EI, using rule 2 and rule 4. So this string is definitely in the language of our grammar. I could also have picked rule 2 followed by rule 3, and then eventually this will boil down to EI plus I. EI, EI. Anyway, so this string is also in the language of the grammar. Now we have AIB. Well, I can get the A and the B from this rule 1 here, but then if I don't want to make more A's and B's, I have to use this rule 2 to get rid of the S, and that requires that I bring in this E, and there's no E in this string, so that's not looking good. All right, how about this? AABB, I can get that by looping around the first rule twice. And then EI, yeah, this string is in the language of the grammar. Over here, I've got the A and the B around it. You'll note that these A's and B's follow the same balanced parenthesis pattern we've been doing a few times. So the real question is whether EI plus can be generated from S. Well, we can get the E, we can get the I, but if we use the plus rule, it has to have an E on both sides. So, you know, we really need another I in here, but we don't have it. So this string is not in the language of the grammar.